Was created back in 1930, but now she's got an updated image and she's inspiring a brand new generation of young girls to solve all sorts of problems through a new game. Joining me now is one of the game's creators from Her Interactive, CEO Penny Milliken. Welcome.
Thank you.
How are you? So, kids still read the books?
Yes, kids still
they
read
do.
The books.
Okay, good. Even if they don't, their parents remember Nancy
Everyone
Drew.
Everyone knows Nancy Drew.
So, how do you explain her popularity?
Well, you know, Nancy Drew has been influencing women and girls for generations. Fans include former First Lady Laura Bush, three Supreme Court justices, the list goes on and on. You may not remember the details of any of those books there.
I do. The Mystery of the Moss-Covered Mansion was my favorite book growing up.
But I bet you remember Nancy Drew,
I
her
do.
Characteristics.
Yeah, yes.
She's generous. She helps others. She is determined. She is going to solve the mystery. She's confident. And her brain is her superpower. So I think even 86 years after she was created, she's still a great role model for girls.
Absolutely. And it gives, it has given girls always kind of a way to see themselves inside the story.
Exactly.
Which wasn't always, you know, so common. So what have you done with it to kind of bring her to a new platform?
Well, in 1998, Her Interactive actually was a pioneer because we brought the books to video games.
Mm-hmm.
The first to do that. We've released 32 games since then, since 1998.
Wow. How did I not know this?
We have a really strong fan base. And one of the things we've learned is that our fans have gone into STEM, that's science, technology, mm-hmm. engineering, and math, because of playing our games.
This is such an important thing because a lot of the games, especially early games, were created more with boys in mind. And I think that obviously had an influence, and there are other cultural and social influences that kind of herd girls a little bit away from STEM education. So using these same platforms to try to welcome them into STEM is a very useful thing.
Oh, exactly. And in fact, a woman, one of our fans, was invited to the White House Science Fair this past year, and she attributed to playing our games the reason why she went into computer programming.
Man.
You hear that all the time.
That's incredible.
Boys, but that's great for
yeah,
girls.
Yeah, that's really good. So what have you brought here?
Well, because our core games, what we call our core games, influence kids to go into STEM, we said, can we get early learners excited about STEM? Can we pique their interest?
Mm-hmm.
So we created Nancy Drew, Codes and Clues. This is Nancy, a tween Nancy, which is not in the books.
Great.
Bess and
so
George.
She's grown up a little bit.
A little bit. She's nine.
Yeah. Okay.
She's nine. And we wanted to add the STEM element. So it's still a story-driven mobile game.
Mm-hmm.
There are six chapters. In each of the chapters, you have an undercover disguise because there's a mystery to solve. There's hidden object games to find the clues.
Love those.
And at the end of each chapter, Nancy has her robot puppy now.
Hello.
And if you remember in the original books,
Nancy, I want a purple robot puppy.
Nancy had a dog in her original book, Toga.
Yeah.
So now in today's world, we're not in books, we're in a mobile, we're in a digital platform. We have a digital dog. And what this puppy does, he helps Nancy out of sticky situations at the end of each chapter. For instance, in the first chapter, they get locked in the classroom and only the puppy can get through the vent to get them out. Cute things like that.
But all of it is involving developing problem-solving skills that are based on some of the material that you would have in STEM education,
exactly.
Correct?
Yes.
Okay. So are the games for your phone, for your computer, for everything?
They're mobile. They're for your phone. They're not for computer. They're mobile.
So both Android and
iOS.
Whatever the other
thing is. Yes.
Yeah, I can't even think about that. So how is this developed? I mean, how do you approach an iconic character like this, but also have in mind this other purpose and figure out how to make great stories out of it? Because frankly, nobody's going to say, oh, I want to play this game so that I can be better at STEM. I want to play the game
because
it's
fun. You have to remember, you're 5 to 8 year olds,
yeah.
So you want to have fun. What we want to do is pique their interest in STEM while solving a fun Nancy Drew mystery.
Mm-hmm.
So when they go to school and they're introduced to block coding, they'll remember, gosh, Nancy Drew, I had fun programming that robot puppy. Let's learn more about block coding. Programming.
That is so cool. Well, I mean, frankly, I don't know this. Could I learn from this game
yes,
as well?
Yes, you could.
So I should not. There's no shame if I decide I want to play the Nancy Drew game.
No, not at all. And one of the things we find is that parents, especially mothers, enjoy playing with their daughters because because they're reliving their Nancy Drew memories while introducing their young daughters to Nancy Drew in a different form, but they're having a lot of fun.
What's your view of the overall gaming industry, both the participants in the gaming industry in terms of designers and companies producing these games, and output for girls specifically, or that at least equally include girls? Where are we going with this?
I think you're seeing more and more of that. I was at a recent game developers conference, and I met with 25, 30 young women who are all interested in the gaming industry, whether from a writing standpoint, mm-hmm. a programming standpoint, an art standpoint. So that's really exciting to see.
And that was not the way when you started out.
No, not in 1998. As I said, Peru Interactive was a pioneer in creating video games for girls.
Well, we appreciate this very much. Yes. I'm all over it. So if it's cool for someone of my age, if I have not aged out of Nancy Drew, I am on top of this.
Drew.
Thank you so much. To get you started, Penny brought vouchers for everybody in the audience to download the game for free. So enjoy. Okay, up next, some important fireworks safety reminders for kids. We'll be right back. Thank you so much.